Okey-dokey. All right, so here's what I'm doing here. Got a microscope. Me kick it up a notch here. Hey, what's up? All right. It's hard to keep it perfectly flat because I don't have the best stand for it. Kind of improvised one. Right, that looks pretty good. You can't normally there's like a ring of lights that are going around everything, so let's so you can see the ring of lights showing. Oh, that looks so much better. Perfect. Oh, nope. Okay, that looks close. All right, so I think this looks pretty close as well. Yeah. Very, 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 as much in focus as it can be. So here's what I'm going for here. Oh yeah. So look at this. Right there. Got my first 2021 penny. Admittedly, I've been using my card pretty heavily the last few months, but I finally went a few places, spent some money, got some change, and lo and behold, here's 2021's first Lincoln cent for me. It's kind of boring. I'm not really looking for damage, but I've got some newer ones. That's cool. I've got some new ones to try. Oh, yeah. I think this will work with the microphone. Let me see. Can you hear me? Yeah, well, that looks good. Perfect. I think it'll pick up everything. As long as it lasts. All right. Look at this. That's a little bit better. Yep. Here's one thing I didn't expect to find, actually. They've got little VDB at the bottom. You see this right here? VDB. It's actually really hard to to show with the scope. I need like a pin of some kind. But yeah, I thought that was kind of interesting. So this year, they're putting the VDB logo on the pennies, and I didn't realize that. It's kind of cool. What does in God mean? Well, when you connect it, God we. It's cool because I haven't been able to see the way it looks. Oh, there we go. Now I can actually see it. I like this view though. I think the view looks pretty cool, but I can't figure out what all the marks were on the penny. Because the way it came, there's like all these little black specks that you see. You can see like at this level, way up here. You can see another black speck way over here. And I cleaned it off with an alcohol wipe. And it definitely took stuff off, but then the penny was a bit more scuffed after that. Look at this, though. This, like, some of the marks on it are super irritating. But I've got other ones. So, for example, here's one I just got today. So notice, it has the exact same scuff above the eye, right? So that's kind of a bummer, but if you look around, this one has all the exact same, like, kind of errors that the other ones have. I'm not really sure where all these little errors came from, or if it's like a result of something, but it seems kind of, I don't know. Something worth noting, right? So then if I look at another one. Now if I look at another 2021 penny. And we start over here with Liberty. This one doesn't really have a scratch. But it does have some of those marks I'm talking about. And so just like the hurried or the shoddy craftsmanship on some of these pennies. It's kind of worrisome. I wonder if it was like outsourced or exactly what the behind the scenes of releasing pennies, because I've never seen pennies with this many errors in it before. So here's another 2021 penny right here. Look at this. Same, like all these little specks that have like, not really sure where they've come from, but everything kind of doing the errors here. Look at that. So it's pretty epic, right? I suppose I could get, maybe like last year's. Check this out. Check this out. So no scratch above the eye on this one. But it does still have those distinct, like, pock marks, whatever those are. I'm not really sure what they are. This one just has kind of a different luster to it. I've got a light control on this thing. So I can, like, do no light and just see what it looks like. That's kind of cool. Then, I can go to this mode and just do, like, a little bit of illumination. Can see the scratch above the R in Liberty. Good shot, though, you know. I don't know what this little mark is down here, but it looks like JS. Look at this dime. Look at this action. Little scratch marks on it. Whoa, this one's super old. Look at this one. Compare it to this one. Definitely. Oh, the JS thing is still there. You can still see the little JS on this level. When you can see it on this level too. Ooh, now here's a super old penny. Yeah. Whoa. Now I'm going to turn the light up a whole bunch. Now, I'm going to turn the light down. So that's just with just a little bit of light, not full blast. I can't tell if that's a burn mark or something else on here, but it sure looks like it, you know? Hey man, you ever look at a penny with a microscope? Look at this. Look up, you can kind of see in the middle where you have like the figure of Abraham Lincoln.
Right. Everyone knows that, but not everybody knows it.
So if you look right above my head. Right above my head, you can see what's supposed to be Abraham Lincoln.
Right here. It's so much easier just doing it that way. Oh yeah, it's way easier. Okay, there we go.
Could be the spy from TF2, though. Apparently, this is the number 6 or FG. That one not as interesting. What have we here? 79. Look at this one. Oh wow, yeah. Here's the 1975. That's kind of cool. I like that. Look at this action. I'm really interested in things like the wear patterns, but also just the frequency of certain years. I'm just taking a moment just to look at it with a microscope. Oh.
Same year. Different life path, you know what I'm saying? This one's been through stuff. His penny is horribly tarnished. Yeah, see, this one's why you wash your hands occasionally. Don't worry, though, I'm a professional. This one's rough, though. This is a, I got this penny, I'm pretty confident, during the pandemic. And I'm vaccinated, so should be okay. So let's take a moment to appreciate what a real penny looks like, right? Whoop. I've got another 1975. I'm coming up with ways to display this. I'm just experimenting right now. Because I wasn't sure how I was going to use the microscope, or if I was going to use it in like an effective way. So I've got this. Alright. So, 2021, right? And then, here's another 1975. Okay. 79. Okay. 68. Ooh, before the summer of love. This penny's been around. Look at this penny right here. This is a good one. 1968. All right. Wow. Compare the printing on these letters to a previous one that's been shown. Liberty or Liberty. I need to make a little template to put the pennies on, so they're always like centered on little circles that are certain distances apart. I can automate the recognition of the years or the like the errors and whatnot. So that's 68. What do I got over here? 81. Ooh, look at this one. And it has no Denver mint mark. So this is probably an East Coast penny. It seems like the letters are outlined in black on these pennies, right? And then I go over to something like this, and it's so much different. They're just, like, crammed up there. It almost looks like, what's that animation? Okay, let's see. Compare it to a 1981. Compared to 1975. Compared to 1975. Somebody filed down the T on this one, apparently, or got smacked down. Compared to 2021. Oh. Whoa. That one's pretty decent, but again, I just kind of look at, like, maybe it looked more like this one, but over time, they just kind of got smashed down or spread out, and that's maybe how you get, let's see here, where is it, a 1968 penny, because look at that. This is so old, but I've got older pennies. I'm kind of curious what some of them look like. See what else I can find. Give me a second. This is how it came, like an error in the lamination, I imagine, or however it was laid down. I think maybe somebody smashed it. Could have scraped it on a curb, but you see the VDB down there? Just sneaking it on in. Compared to the 2021, where you can actually kind of tell it's there. That's not the penny I was looking for, though. I was looking for a different penny. Oh, now here is a treat. Boa. Balboa. That's pretty cool. I'll take that one. I forgot I had that coin. I remember getting it in change at some point. So apparently that came from Panama. Nineteen 55, old school. Bit of a smashed coin here. Whoa, old school. Oh, that's great. There we go. I need to bump the stream up to 1080 though, I think.
Ooh, there we go. Brought out some detail in the metalwork. I need to get a proper stand, but unfortunately, I just kind of threw something together as usual. I prefer to get things operational and worry about the specifics later. You know, make something work. Well, oh, that's kind of interesting. There's a bunch of like scratch taken out of it. Lib. Oops. Oh, and there it is. So, some good coins on here. So that's one, it's a 1968, and then here's another 1968 that's in much better condition. So let's look at like We Trust, or I guess We Trust. I guess for the meme, we can just do Russ. Look at the difference, though. Just the difference in wear. So this 1968 penny, this thing has been through quite a lot of hands, a lot of experiences. Whereas you look at this penny, and this seems more like, you know, maybe something that was water damaged at one point, got tossed in a drawer. But for the most part, it is what it was when it was created back in probably 67, 68 sometime. And then again, just look how amazing it is when you pull over to a very used example. Obviously, I haven't taken the time to clean these ones because that's not the purpose that I'm going for right here. What I'm going for is instead just kind of looking at the wear and tear with the microscope. Other times that I do this, I do a lot more where I'll do statistics on the probability of certain pennies based on like decades, whatever. But so far, I needed to branch out and do something a little bit different. And after that heat wave we just had in Seattle, I felt like just trying something else. A little bit more low energy, you know what I'm saying? So that's pretty cool. And then here's like a random Panama coin. I wish I could zoom out a little bit. I probably could, but can you guess what year this coin happens to be? Like, can you guess? So this might be a very old coin for some people. Booyah. So here's 1964 coming up. 1964. So this is after quite the tumultuous time in US history. So you look at this coin, and this coin dealt with a lot of the fallout of what happened in 1964, you know? Let's see here.
It's hard to decide if I want to stretch the screen or just keep it pixel perfect or whatever. Yeah, this coin has definitely been through some stuff. Damn. Wow, this one has a bit more flair. Now it just says Liberty. Do 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 do. The penny is so light, the paper picks it up, so I can tap the paper to give a little bit of an adjustment to the lighting that shows up. Do like Morse code. Look at that. The difference, pretty striking. Anyways, this one's been through a lot. The other one, not so much. I wish I could find a wheat back, though. That's what I'm really looking for. I need to look at a really old penny. I lost a coin.
This one's from 2017, as you can tell, but it's the Philadelphia Mint, the first time they put the P back on the penny in a good number of years. I don't remember the exact year they stopped doing it. This one's quite a find, though. This one, I didn't know I was going to find, and then I found it, so I was pretty pumped about that. Very few of those were really found, because most of these went on the East Coast. Whereas on the West Coast, ours will have a D. So that one's pretty cool. Look at the difference in color on these pennies. They're both brand new, essentially uncirculated. Yet the newer pennies definitely have something about them, you know? There we go. So, back to this one, huh?
Okay, so here's one that I've been looking for. I've got a bit of a collection, so it's kind of hard to find all of these, but this one right here is actually what I've been, one of the ones I've been looking for. So you can see, same thing. Liberty's on there. It's very worn. So this one is actually quite old. 34. This one's got a lot of history in there. I've got older coins, but I'm still... I stacked them in a thing with a particular orientation, so I'm trying to figure out which ones have which ones. Old school. Look at that, though. Oops. Nope. It is so freaking bright. It's hard to get them both in the same frame, but it's not that I'm not trying. I was just curious what the scale was in comparison. Kind of have to choose one or the other. At this scale, at least. So the one thing I wanted to check on the 1934 penny, of course, is that, you know, this one's a little bit different. It's this wheat back penny. So the back is completely different compared to the new one. Let's see here. Compared to, say, a 1959. So we've got our newer coin. With the shield on it, as you might expect. We've got the old school coin that has Abraham Lincoln inside the Lincoln Memorial. Okay. And then we've got the super old school wheatback penny. There's a lot more variation. That's three different types, though. Unfortunately, there's a bit of a hair on this one. I still think it's kind of interesting. Most people don't know that Lincoln is in the background.1959 happens to be the last year that the wheatback pennies would be a thing. So the kind of the reason I'm comparing these three, we've got the modern equivalent in the middle, and then this 1934 example is, of course, the wheatback penny. And over here, this 1959, this is the Lincoln Memorial penny back. So kind of just looking at the differences from year to year, because they're pretty good, examples of what you want to see in terms of definition. Like, obviously, this is the newest one. And what I really want, I should have my second monitor for this, but I need to overlay them. Just kind of looking at the differences and how things changed over time. Look at that chin. Look at that chin on Lincoln. Holy cow, wait. Look at this chin from 1959. I think it's more of a beard than a chin, but if we skip over here, yeah, you can see it's still there, but it's got some more definition from the 2021. And then we go to 1934, and there's not a lot left of the beard, it seems. Those were actually cool to find, so I wasn't sure where they were. Don't drop the coins. Apparently, I thought this was worth keeping. 1970 S. Look how high up that S is. Pretty epic. Ooh. All right, here's another good one. Coming in with 1949. Booyah. Look at that one. Woo. It's definitely a D down there, though. shake this thing out. Can't tell, but it's on the moon. Here's a crater. Here's another crater on the moon. Do 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 do. Yes. This is something they give when you buy the sets from the mint. I think it comes with the roll. So it's like definitely uncirculated, but I found it in circulation. This is what you would get with your collection when you buy like the year's coins and they all come together in like a really nice set. On the other side, it has a mark identifying the mint, in this case, P for Philadelphia. That's kind of cool. I happen to get one of these by chance. What does this say? Philadelphia. Says uncirculated, but I found it in circulation. I got it at a Jack in the Box. Kind of a cool find. This is an old school coin of mine, though. This is when I got really serious with coin collecting. Well, I think that's going to be about it for the evening. I got to get more organized to do that a little bit better. Whoops, wrong one. But for the most part, I've got everything set up the way I want it to be. Now I just need to bring in the collection and kind of do what I was intending to do, which is go through and count everything. For what it's worth, I just washed my hands. This is Iceman West signing off. Thanks for everyone who was hanging out.